My name is Tapelo Paul from AmaZulu Football Club. I started playing football at a very young age, and I used to give my mom a lot of trouble as I used to play outside with older guys and go to an extent of going to taverns to watch some games. Growing up, my family did support me, and they still are in terms of what I do. I was never denied a chance to go play a game or to go to training. My friends as well, they gave me the support I needed, even though it didn't make sense to them, especially when it came to me choosing football over my studies and putting my studies on hold for football. I got my first professional contract in year 2014. Coach George organized a trial for me to come to AmaZulu. I came for a trial for a week. They called me again for another week, and then I managed to impress the coaching staff, which was then Coach Drake Rosley with Coach Fox, and then they gave me the contract in 2014. With my first salary, I had to buy a phone, because at the time I was using my sister's phone and it was giving me problems, so I decided to buy a phone and send some money home with the same salary, because I needed something to connect with my family, and the thing that I can use then, it was only a phone, so I had to buy myself a proper phone that I can use to communicate with my family. There is difficulties being a professional football player. Some people don't know about them, but there is difficulties in terms of one, managing the finances, managing all the family members that you come across with, and managing your community, because you start to have a lot of people getting to know you, people who didn't know you before, and you have to manage all of those people and the expectations as well, because the demands also, because it's business. As much as it's a passion for us, but there's business side of it. So you have to manage all of that and manage your own self, because you have to take care of your body, make sure that your body is always in good condition in every possible way. And mentally, you have to have a strong mental hold to withstand all of these things that I've already said, because they all come in handy. But you have to manage all of that. So the difficulties are there, even though sometimes to people it seems like it's easy, but it's not. I'm very excited about going back, because we've been in lockdown for almost 3 months now. It's not been an easy time for us. We are used to training outside and interacting with the teammates and all of that, but for the last 2.5 months to 3 months, it's not been happening, and it's been frustrating for us, but we have to come to understand that health is more important than anything. So we had to oblige by the rules and make sure that we follow all the lockdown rules. So now that we're going back, it's exciting times for us. We still have a situation at hand with my club, AmaZulu, which we have to deal with. As much as exciting times for us, we still have a war in front of us, so we are aware of that. As a defender, there's strikers you don't like to face, and I know there's a lot of strikers in PSL with good qualities. But a striker that comes to mind to me is Bradley Khobler. I played against him in my first season, and I've played against him recently. It's still the same Bradley Khobler that used to give me problems when I was a rookie. It still gives me problems even now. He's a striker that is good in the air, and a striker that can hold the ball up very well. Striker who loves to play on your shoulder. So sometimes when you get those matchups, it's not easy, because sometimes you play on the striker's weakness. But with Bradley, I try to find some weaknesses which are hard to find. But you manage to deal with those as a player, because you also got your own strengths, so you focus on those as well and try to win the battle in terms of making sure that your own strengths come out and show. The surname change came about last season. I used to use my mother's surname, which is Nyong'o, and now I'm using my father's surname, Muxoki. I had to change to my father's surname, as my father followed our traditional ways, which is to go and pay damages and ask my mother's side of the family the permission to use his surname. It's something that I've always knew it's gonna come up. And luckily for me, it came up before I got to have my next phase of life, which is marriage and having kids, because in terms of culture, it's very important for us. I had to change it, because once I have kids and have a wife, I can't use my mother's surname in my father's household, because culturally I do my things on my father's side, so I can't take a surname of another household and put it in my father's household. So I had to change to Uxoki, but my father had to do the right things as well, go and pay damages and go and talk to my mother's side of the family about fixing things, which he did. Hence, I changed to Uxoki. The five things that people don't know about me is I'm afraid of heights. I'm not a person who loves bungee jumping and all of that. I don't love flying as well, but I have to, but I'm afraid of heights. I love animals. I love animal channels. I've got a phobia for cars. This one it's something that people don't really know, but I've got a phobia for cars. I don't really love traveling with cars. Fourth one, I'm a very huge UFC fan. I love fighting. I follow it very often lately. And I can't swim. I know it's not something to be proud of, but I can't swim. I had an incident when I was young. My cousin almost drowned me in the beach. So ever since then, me and water have never been friends. So I avoid at all times swimming. I even almost drowned in one of our recovery sessions, where we were at King's Park pool. But I did manage to be saved by one of my teammates. The journey of Etamazulu has been quite a journey for me, and it still is. There's been a lot of ups and downs, but I would love to focus on the ups more than the downs. But the downs have managed to make me a stronger person, make me a stronger individual as a human being and as a player as well. Because my first season we got relegated. It was tough to take, but I was blessed to have the opportunity to have played some games in the PSL then. And then there was a transition of going to NFD and coming back up, which made me grow as a player as well, because there was a lot of players moving out and players coming in. So I had to take a role of being a captain at a very young age because of such, because a lot of senior guys left the club, and I was left to manage the guys that are coming in as young as I was. But I had to take up a senior player role at my tender age of 21, and I did that with my best of abilities, with some mistakes of course, because as you know, anyone does make mistakes. But I hope I did make a huge impact on the club, and I make a huge impact on the club's progress. And I would love to leave a legacy. My journey here is not finished, so I would love to leave a legacy. I know the person who took me to AmaZulu, Coach George Dennerley. he left a huge legacy to the club, and he always reminds me of that. He won the cup in 1992 for the club, and he was a top goal scorer then. And I would love to do the same, even though I will never reach his top goal scorer record. But I would love to win something for the club as well, and leave my own legacy to the club, because that's the chats we normally have between me and him, amongst our chats that we have. But I would love to have my own legacy that I can brag about. The message of support to the supporters. These are difficult times for everyone, and I know it's not easy on anyone. We are trying by all means to manage wherever we can. And unfortunately, I know some of our supporters may have lost their jobs during this pandemic, and some are struggling to make ends meet. But I would love to say to them, they must hang on. Better times are coming. There's a saying that says, nothing lasts forever. This shall pass too. Even though it seems bleak for now, but it will pass. And let's stay strong and safe, and make sure that we oblige by the government rules of social distancing, wearing masks and sanitizing and all of that, in order for us to stay safe. And I would love to encourage them to support us, even though I know it's gonna be a tricky situation now that we may play behind closed doors. But we would love their support either way. So to everyone that's out there of AmaZulu, please make sure that you keep on supporting AmaZulu. We'll try and do our best to make sure the team survives, and make sure that we make you proud in the seasons ahead. So that's it for me. Thank you. Hebe, usuthu.